The drive to be the game's best starts out here. And more importantly, it starts this young. Guy Gaudreau just needed incentive for his 2-year-old son, Johnny. And he found it in a box of candy.
The first few months was pretty much a waste of time. Just laid on the ice. And then I had some older kids I used to coach. They were 16-year-olds. And I'd have them come out with Skittles. And they'd put a Skittle right on the ice, about 10 feet in front of him. So he'd either crawl to it or try to skate to it, and he'd pick the Skittle up and eat the Skittle, because he loved Skittles. So we bribed him to move around a little bit, and then, so he would eat Skittles, and we'd entertain him for an hour. Until then he turned 3 years old, 2 to 3 years old, he started moving around pretty well. By three, he was scooting around pretty well, you know, so. And by four, we were into learning to play, playing, and doing tournaments, and so that's how he pretty much started.
I mean, I don't remember much, but I remember my parents telling me stories, endless amount of stories about me at the rink, sleeping on the bench if it was too early of a game, doing snow angels on the ice, like you said, the candy and stuff like that. And I think it's something pretty unique because my dad got the chance to have a rink and get to do those things with me. It was really special.
Out of Skittles came skill, a natural ability that allowed young Johnny Gaudreau to outperform kids his age and even older. Couple that with a love for the game that separates the passive player from one with passion.
He wanted to be on the ice and he wanted to have more ice time. And, I don't know if you know John Stevens, used to be the Flyers coach. I coached his son, Johnny, little Johnny Stevens, when Maddie was the same age. And John would come out and practice with us. And when Matthew's team was practicing, and John would say, "Well, I think you have him on the ice too much." I said, "Well, he just chose to come out. He just got done his practice. He wants to do another practice."
He, like so many other hockey players, growing up, they tend to miss out on a lot. Like, he has never been to one homecoming dance. He's never been to a prom. He didn't graduate with his senior class. He missed his 8th grade graduation dance because there was either a hockey tournament or something, you know, along hockey. And he always chose to, you know, we always gave him that choice.
Johnny Gaudreau was the pint-sized player who had dreams well out of his reach. Aspirations of a career that few kids ever attain. Dreams that even a mom and dad couldn't quite wrap their hands around.
People would ask him what he wanted to do when he grew up, and he would say, "I want to be an NHL player." And then my husband would say, "Jane, we have to talk him. We have to really let him know that he's not going to be an NHL player. You know, there's only a very small percentage. He's going to be small. We need to like try to redirect him in another
area.
I've actually told him. I said, "Listen, John, look at your dad and look at your mom. We're not 6'3", 6'4". And there's a lot of them. But I'm going to tell you one thing. I will never discourage you from working hard and trying to obtain your goal. But you have to understand, it's going to be twice as hard for you as it is for anybody else."
But 4 years ago, Johnny's career skyrocketed. At the age of 17, he left home to join the United States Hockey League in Dubuque, Iowa. Not long after, the Calgary Flames took a shot at the 5'9" forward, selecting him in the 4th round of the 2011 draft.
If he'd have stayed here, he never got drafted. Things might have changed, been different. But I just the courage it took for him to do that, to leave all his friends and to go out, to me is the most amazing thing he's ever done in his hockey career. You know, I mean, I knew at that point that when he went out, I told my wife when we dropped him off, like my heart just like when we were leaving, I just like felt, I can't believe I'm leaving my 17-year-old son, who just barely turned 17, in Dubuque.
Following on the advice of Flyers captain Keith Primo, Gaudreau also embarked on one of the most remarkable careers at Boston College. Now a 2-time All-American, a national champion, the NCAA scoring champ, and the surefire favorite to win the Hobey Baker Award.
His hockey speaks for itself. It just, you know, you watch him play and you know exactly what you have as a hockey player. But as a person, he You know, it just took us a while because he's so quiet, so unassuming, and doesn't want to be first in line. Doesn't have to be the first guy to get this, first guy to get that. But, you know, as the years go by, we've had him 3 years now. He's a better person than he is a player. That's awfully hard for someone who's looked at him and says, how could he ever be a better person? But he really is.
I always wanted to go to BC since I was 5, 6 years old, just watching BC hockey. But the one thing that stuck out to me was how he told me how he let smaller guys be creative, and you know, they're not going to just be on a third, fourth line, just getting a shift here and there. They're going to be our key player.
In 3 seasons, Johnny Gaudreau has become the king of Chestnut Hill, and he has the name to go along with the game. And you can see why the Johnny hockey craze is not only popular on campus, but across the country as well.
Do you like the label Johnny hockey?
It's cute. It's you know, it's different. You know, I mean, when I'm starting to get used to it now.
Because we all know Johnny football.
Yeah.
I think the world's about to learn who Johnny hockey is. Yeah.
It's tough for me to talk to people. I'm kind of a shy person. But you know, something that I need to adjust to, like you said. It's great to see kids come up to me and talk to me and stuff like that. But it's also something I gotta definitely learn to do a little better.
Just a few classes short of graduating, all signs for Johnny Gaudreau are now pointing to a career in the NHL, and the belief that heart can indeed overcome height.
Now, the one trait you have to have is you gotta have a big heart, because you gotta play against, you know, huge size disadvantage. You can't be afraid to go into, you know, grinding type areas, but you have to be really strong in your skates. Now, there's weight room strength, I've always thought, and then there's on ice strength. And if you can control your edges and are strong in your blades, you can become very, very strong in the ice. Johnny, for what he lacks in the weight room, he is strong in pucks. His turning ability, his elusiveness, so he becomes a strong player once the puck game starts. But I think John is that unique, special person that can prosper at whatever level.